Hairy Leucoplakia, Wikipedia Audio. Hairy Leucoplakia, 385L, or HIV-associated hairy leucoplakia, is a white patch on the side of the tongue with a corrugated or hairy appearance. It is caused by Epstein-Barr virus and occurs usually in persons who are immunocompromised, especially those with human immunodeficiency virus infection / acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. This white lesion cannot be scraped off. The lesion itself is benign and does not require any treatment, although its appearance may have diagnostic and prognostic implications for the underlying condition. Depending upon what definition of leucoplakia is used, hairy leucoplakia is sometimes considered a subtype of leucoplakia, or a distinct diagnosis. In a classification of the oral lesions in HIV disease, OL is grouped as lesions strongly associated with HIV infection. It could also be classed as an opportunistic, viral disease. Hairy leucoplakia occurs on the tongue and has a similar name to hairy tongue, but these are separate conditions with different causes. Classification. There are no symptoms associated with the lesion itself, although many and varied symptoms and signs may be associated with the underlying cause of immunosuppression. The lesion is a white patch, which almost exclusively occurs on the lateral surfaces of the tongue, although rarely it may occur on the buccal mucosa, soft palate, pharynx, or esophagus. The lesion may grow to involve the dorsal surface of the tongue. The texture is vertically corrugated or thickly furrowed and shaggy in appearance. The white appearance is created by hyperkeratosis and epithelial hyperplasia. The causative agent implicated is Epstein-Barr virus, the same virus that causes infectious mononucleosis. After the primary EBV infection has been overcome, the virus will persist for the rest of the host's life and hides from the immune system by latent infection of B lymphocytes. The virus also causes lytic infection in the oropharynx, but is kept in check by a normal, functioning immune system. Uncontrolled lytic infection is manifested as oral hairy leucoplakia in immunocompromised hosts. OL usually arises where the immunocompromise is secondary to HIV/AIDS. Rarely are other causes of immunocompromise associated with OL, but it has been reported in people who have received transplants and are taking immunosuppressive medication. OL may also accompany chronic graft versus host disease. Even more rare are reports of OL in persons with competent immune systems. The white lesion cannot be wiped away, unlike some other common oral white lesions, e.g. pseudomembranous candidiasis, and this may aid in the diagnosis. Diagnosis of OL is mainly clinical, but can be supported by proof of EBV in the lesion and HIV serotesting. When clinical appearance alone is used to diagnose OL, there is a false positive rate of 17% compared to more objective methods. The appearance of OL in a person who is known to be infected with HIV does not usually require further diagnostic tests as the association is well known. OL in persons with no known cause of immunocompromise usually triggers investigations to look for an underlying cause. If tissue biopsy is carried out, the histopathologic appearances of hyperplastic and parakeratinized epithelium, with balloon cells in the upper stratum spinosum and nuclear beading in the superficial layers. Candida usually is seen growing in the parakeratin layer, but there are no normal inflammatory reactions to this in the tissues. There is no dysplasia. Treatment is not necessary since the lesion is benign, however the person may have aesthetic concerns about the appearance. The condition often resolves rapidly with high-dose acyclovir or dacyclovir but recurs once this therapy is stopped, or as the underlying immunocompromise worsens. Topical use of podophyllum resin or retinoids has also been reported to produce temporary remission. Antiretroviral drugs such as zidovudine may be effective in producing a significant regression of all. Recurrence of the lesion may also signify that highly active antiretroviral therapy is becoming ineffective. The oral lesion itself is benign and self-limiting, however, this may not necessarily be the case for the underlying cause of immunocompromise. For instance, OAL with HIV/AIDS is a predictor of bad prognosis. Hairy leukoplakia is one of the most common oral manifestations of HIV/AIDS, along with oral candidiasis. It is the most common HIV/AIDS-related condition caused by EBV, although EBV-associated lymphomas may also occur. OAL mainly occurs in adult males, less commonly in adult females and rarely in children. The incidence rises as the CD4 count falls, and the appearance of OAL may signify progression of HIV to AIDS. A study from 2001 reported a significant decrease in the incidence of some oral manifestations of AIDS, which was attributed to the use of HART, whilst the incidence other HIV-associated oral lesions did not alter significantly. Oral hairy leukoplakia was first described by Greenspan et al. In 1984, a few years after the start of the AIDS epidemic. A link with OAL was not initially reported as scientific understanding of HIV/AIDS was just beginning to unfold during this time. Later, it was thought to occur only in HIV-infected, homosexual males. However, this is now known not always to be the case. It has been suggested that OAL be renamed according to its causative factor as EBV leukoplakia. Signs and symptoms. Causes. Diagnosis. Treatment. Prognosis. Epidemiology. History. Research directions.